Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother in law.
Beautiful. Tina, give him a big hug. Big kiss. That's right.
How you doing?
I'm doing.
Thank you, Daryl. Daryl, you can move back because I don't want you to run over that pretty gown.
Don't do it, Dad.
We'd like to welcome each and every one of you today for such a beautiful celebration and unifying of two beautiful people. We're gathered today in the presence of family and friends to celebrate the love and devotion which Scott and Dina have for one another. To acknowledge their decision to commit their lives and accept each other completely, and to extend our wishes of happiness and our fondest hopes to the words that shall unite them in the special union we call marriage. Marriage has been described as the best and most important relationship that can exist between a man and a woman. It's a very unique connection of two people united for a common purpose, bringing love and trust together into single focus. Marriage is the clasping of hands, the blending of two hearts, the union of two lives into one. And your marriage must stand not by the authority of the state, nor by the seal of your wedding certificate, but by the strength and the power of faith and in the love you have for each other. No one says marriage is easy. To make this relationship work will take love. This is the core of your marriage and why you are both here today. I would ask that you always remember to cherish each other as a distinct individual as you are, that you respect the thoughts, ideas, and suggestions of one another. Allow yourselves to forgive and do not hold grudges. Never go to sleep angry. And always kiss each other goodnight. A marriage that lasts is one that is continually developing while growing in and understanding of each other. The understanding of each other can be the greatest and most rewarding experience of your lives. Since it is your intent to enter into a solemn matrimony, I first ask you, Scott. You're holding back the smile, Scott. I can see you really want to smile. You can smile.
She's taking pictures.
Do you take Dina to be your wife, to live together in marriage, to love her, honor, and respect her? Do you commit yourself to her happiness and self-fulfillment as a person? And do you promise to keep only unto her, forsaking all others, until you are parted by death?
I do.
Okay. Dina, beautiful smile as well. Do you take Scott to be your husband, to live together in marriage, to love him, honor, and respect him? Do you commit yourself to his happiness and self-fulfillment as a person? And do you promise to keep only unto him, forsaking all others, until you are parted by death?
I do.
She's louder than you are, Scott.
You guys got a mic with me?
Yeah. Today you are making public for all to know that the words, I love you, repeat after me, I love you.
I love you.
Are a full commitment of yourselves to each other. There are many definitions of this love, and to explain the one I'm speaking of right now, I will read this. And these, of course, these are words and phrases that you have selected to be read today. Love is gentleness. Love is kindness. Love understands and love forgives. It is loyal through the good and the bad. Love hopes for the future. Love is everlasting. Love makes up for the thing that you may not have. Without love, no matter what you do have, seems never enough. So, search for love. Share your love, but most of all, enjoy your love. Such love requires us to be totally honest with yourself and your mate, and ask what you want. Take action even when you are afraid. Share your feelings and listen, but leave your partner to be free to be who they really are. In other words, love your partner for who they are, not for who you think they should be. Marriage can be a great adventure when it comes to the outward expression of great love. It is the expression you will share right now with the reciting of your marriage vows. Remember, there are no human ties more tender and no other vows more important than those you now assume. Dina, can you please pass your bouquet to Shauna? Hold hands, look deeply into each other's eyes, and repeat after me. That's not yet, that's okay. I, Scott, take you, Dina.
I, Scott, take you, Dina.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in life and one true love.
My partner in life and one true love.
I will cherish our union.
I will cherish our union.
And love you more each day.
And love you more and more and more each day.
Than I did before.
Than I did before.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
Loving you faithfully.
Loving you faithfully.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
Regardless of the obstacles that we might face together.
You are my best friend.
You are my best friend.
And I will love and respect you always.
And I will love and respect you always.
I give you my hand.
Give you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And all my love.
And all my love.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Dina. Okay, you want to take a look? Okay. All right, Dina, you ready? Dina? Scott? I take you, Scott. Can I get some of that too? I want to be left out. I, Dina.
I, Dina.
Take you, Scott.
Take you, Scott.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one and only true love.
I will cherish our union.
I will cherish our union.
And love you more each day.
And love you more and more each day.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh and I will cry with you.
Loving you faithfully.
Loving you so faithfully.
Regardless of the obstacles.
Regardless of all obstacles.
That we may face together.
That we will face together.
Am I reading wrong? Am I just... You are my best friend.
You are my best friend.
And I will love and respect you always.
And I will love and respect you always.
I give you my hand.
I give you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And all of my love from this day forward.
And all of my love from this day forward.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live. And until we meet in heaven.
Throughout time, the ring has been a symbol of unending love. Because like time, the ring has no beginning and no end. It is a circle, the emblem of eternity. The ring finger on the left hand, the side of the body that holds the heart, has been used for the wedding band because of centuries. People believe there was a vein that ran directly from the finger to the heart. They also believe that the words spoken during the placing of the wedding band would resonate over and over again like the circumference of the band itself, through to the heart and soul of both the giver and receiver of the most monumental of all promises, the promise of a lifetime as husband and wife. Ron, may I have the rings, please? Thank you, Ron. All right. Scott, go ahead and place that on Dina's left ring finger. And repeat after me. Dina, with this ring.
Dina, with this ring.
I pledge my love and commitment to you.
I pledge my love and commitment to you.
Now and forever.
Now and forever and always.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
Dina, you want to place this ring on Scott's left ring finger and repeat after me. Scott, with this ring.
Scott, with this ring.
I pledge my love and commitment to you.
I pledge my love and my commitment to you.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
On this beautiful day, and I mean beautiful day, 83 degrees.
Beautiful.
5 mile per hour wind blowing in a northeasterly direction. The two of you have chosen to live your lives together in solemn matrimony, and all of us have witnessed as you made your vows to one another. May you strive all your lives to meet this commitment with the same love and devotion that you now possess. What you have promised each other today, you must rededicate tomorrow and each day afterwards. As you enter this new journey together, I'd like to leave you with this poem. May your joys be as sweet as spring flowers that grow, as bright as a fire when the winter winds blow, as countless as leaves that float down in the fall, as serene as the love that keeps watch over us all. You know, we're about to the end, and I want to definitely say to you at this time and point that I am very honored to have been the one to actually, as I use the term, marry you. And this is a very, very special occasion.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And so by the virtue of authority vested in me as Deputy Commissioner of Civil Marriages, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And under the laws of the state of California, Scott, you may kiss your bride. When she gets ready, we're going to straighten her dress up.
Yeah.
I don't think any of us will ever witness that long a kiss. All right. Here you go, Dina. She has your bouquet for you.
Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure, my great pleasure, to present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Scott Brawley.
So good. How do we stay so long together when everybody said we never would? And just when I start to think they're right, the love has died. There you go, making my heart beat again, heart beat again, heart beat again. There you go, making me feel like a kid. Won't you do it and do it?
I'd like to begin by introducing our grandmother of the groom, Elise Brawley.